Gary Vee came out with his own NFT. And just for some of us that don't really know what NFT is, you guys can Google it, check out. There's a lot of information about NFTs. What it stands for is non-fungible token. And let's look at the fungible, right? That part of the word is, it pretty much is like not interchangeable, meaning it can't really be duplicated. It's its own, what we can call a digital asset. For that's why it's unique. NFTs can represent photos, videos, audios, art, music, sports cards, and all these other popular things. Just in this last year, there was a huge rise in NFT where they tripled in value in 2020 and over $250 million worth of NFT. And most NFTs are part of the Ethereum blockchain. They call it Bitcoin 2.0. There are other blockchains that have developed this type. Ethereum right now is the leading, but doesn't mean that you can't have an NFT coming off a different type of blockchain. So now that we talked about that, what do you guys think about Gary Vee launching his NFT? He's been hyping up this 5-5, so he was launching it today. And then unfortunately, he said there was some delay. Obviously, there was a lot of work to be done here. So he just posted on Instagram about the whole delay and how he'll let us know 24 hours. You know, he's been doing like these doodles and these arts, and you guys have kind of been seeing him drop it over the last few months. If you follow Gary Vee, I've seen it here now and then. You know, he's dropping all these hints and different things, but it's kind of him using how he's like really good at doodling, and he's not even the best artist, but it's one of those things that he kind of uses art to craft something in the NFT space, which is, here's what I respect about Gary Vee. What I like about what he does is he's really all about catching trends and being at the front end. And watching him since way back in the day, right, when he was really just doing his daily Vs, I was all about watching his daily Vs as I was on my way to work, all throughout the day. I really got motivated off his stuff. And then obviously you get to a point where you're just so motivated, he tells you to do, stop consuming his stuff. I know it's kind of like, I don't want to say hypocritical, but it does contradict, where it's like, hey, he wants people to consume his content, but he also wants them to do, like get it done. And what's cool about Gary Vee is he's always at the front end. I mean, you look at Snapchat, you look at TikTok, he was kind of leading that charge to where those platforms blew up. And now we see a lot of people coming out of just the TikTok space and really as new content creators. So he's really always been at the head. And here's what's interesting. I'm gonna give you guys a few takeaways that I got from this movement. And first off, as he launched his NFTs, I see that how he puts a value to it. So yeah, you know, he starts off with all these different characters. There's different characters out there, like you'll see Dinner Deer, you see Supper Sunfish, you see Hangout Hawk, Shadow Scorpion, okay? And they all have a value to it when it comes down to not the piece, because I mean, we see NFTs selling as high as like $600, $800, $900,000 like out there. And we've seen a lot of these type of NFTs, right? And it's kind of crazy. Doesn't make sense, but it also shows the psychology of like where society is going and what people put perceived value in. So these are like digital assets, and he's creating that. You know, if you have one of these, you get access to 3 years in a row of his conference, and there's limited edition of these tokens where, for example, you get to hang out with him on Zoom like a couple times a year, or you go out to his conference and you get only specific access, right? You can shadow Gary Vee. You're able to have dinner with him. You're able to go bowling with them, and you're not just getting access to him, you're also getting access to his network. And it reminds me of like the course creator space or the mastermind space, or you know, you kind of got to pay to play, right? And that's what kind of reminds me of, like, and now he's putting a value to these tokens, and he's creating more of a experience around a community. And you don't just get access to his conferences, you also get access, like I said, to his network, the people that are there. So there's really a lot of value rather than just a doodle. And I see how he's able to really do that. And it's been fascinating. I mean, just by seeing that, seeing his shift and seeing how he's moving and how he's evolved in every phase of where society's going, he's always been like a visionary of the future. And that's what I really like about what he does, you know, and he's really big about it. And he says this one thing that he went back to in 2017. He talks about IP. You know, that intellectual property, and that's kind of like where things are going now. And, you know, blockchain, there's a lot that's going on. I know the feds and people that are like talking about it, like, oh, it's using a lot of energy, but there's a lot of data that says, you know, printing money is way more energy than mining for blockchain and Bitcoin and all that, right? So, you know, there's some left and right, but the interesting part is just seeing how Gary Vee's leveraging himself as an influencer. And that's the thing, a lot of people think right now, okay, and this is where a lot of the wealth is going to be transferred, with people that are able to just take the opportunity. There's a lot of wealth that's going to be transferred in this space from people that literally got nothing to something. It's a lot easier for people, like I said, at his pace to be able to launch their own. But if you can just get in, and if you can know and evaluate the coins, if you can evaluate what blockchains people are going to believe in, because a lot of it, yes, it's perceived value, and that's why now people are following influencers, asking around, all the buzz, right? We've seen a lot of things with like Doge and Ethereum blowing up and all these other blockchains. I mean, being in the space, I haven't really had a lot of attention in it in the last couple of years, as like it was kind of growing. Because I was around it a lot from a lot of the people in this space. And now I'm seeing how, like, especially how Gary Vee is launching his thing, I'm like, there's really something here. So what do you guys think? I mean, like I said, I think it's cool how he attaches a value to an experience. You get to network. You get to be part of his, like, inner circle, mastermind. And he's putting that value around his own tokens. And these tokens are things that can last for a long time. It reminds me of, like, you know, like Disney characters or like Marvel characters, right? Like, it lives forever. You think about Spider-Man, you think about even Batman, you think of like Mickey Mouse with Disney, you think about all these characters, they live on. And he's putting an attachment to and a value to it. If you look at, for example, like Pokemon, they have, and I believe they've been out for almost 25 years. They have a span of 25 years, but they have the most, I believe it's like copyrighted characters attached to that, right? There's like so many different Pokemon within that span in the lifetime that Pokemon has been around. This is kind of like where NFTs are going and these tokens that they're building when it comes to digital art. And there's going to be a shift in the space. I mean, even like you can, you know, quote unquote, starving artist. A lot of these people that are starving artists in the space, right? You guys can make up something. You can literally, like I said, there can be a shift in the space. And yeah, it takes work if you're working from the bottom and whatnot. But you don't need a big following. You really don't. You just need a strategy, and you need to know when you need to go all in and take the window of opportunity when the risk is there. I believe that the people that are always taking the most risk are always the ones that are at the front end anyways, right? Always at the front of the trends, willing to fail, willing to get back up and take the risk. And I kind of see that with Gary Vee and what he's doing. So I adore that. I really, like I said, I enjoy how he's able to attach it to a value with his in-person conference, right? And then he's creating a whole community around it. Interesting stuff. Let me know what you guys think about this. I think NFTs are very interesting. It has gotten big, especially as I keep hearing about it in the last few months. That's why we see Ethereum hitting where it's at right now, at one of its highest it's ever been, ever since it's been out for the past couple years. So a lot of interesting stuff, especially because like Gary Vee is always like at the front end. So let me know what you guys think below. I thought this was an interesting review. I had to share it because it kind of got me thinking of like the future. You know, as people that always like to think about the future and just being visionaries, like I haven't really understood it until I've seen these last couple months things roll out in the space. And I'm very observative, but I don't know, when I'm not into something because I'm so focused on other things, but I guess my mind just kind of gotten open and enlightened. And I've always been pretty open. But seeing how he launched it and seeing how he's moving through it gives me another like perspective of like, wow, this is really where it's going. So, hey, appreciate you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know what you guys think. Drop in the comments. Check them out. And I'll reply. You guys be blessed. Have a great one. Take care. I'm so free. I got no chains running through the wall. Heaven got a playlist. I promise that's my favorite placement. Faithful over famous. Yeah, faithful over. I got no chains on me. I'm so-